Nearly 4 years to the day he died on the floor of a jail cell, new court documents reveal the guards who restrained Soleiman Faqiri in the final moments of his life directly violated use of force rules.
He had a special relationship with each and every single one of us. And it's that void that hasn't gone away. And I don't think it'll ever go away.
Faqiri died December 15th, 2016. He was awaiting a mental health assessment at the Central East Correctional Center in Kawartha Lakes. He had been arrested after allegedly stabbing a neighbor during what his family called a schizophrenic episode. A week and a half later, while on remand at the prison, there was an altercation with several guards, ending with Faqiri's death. Well, tonight, his family is outraged at new revelations about that altercation, including a jail sergeant who was there who acknowledges what happened was wrong. Angelina King has the exclusive story and a warning. It contains graphic images.
He was pepper sprayed, his hands cuffed behind his back, his legs shackled. Laying on his stomach, a spit hood over his head. Then Soleiman Faqiri was briefly left in his cell, an image that still haunts his brother.
This was a Canadian man, a vulnerable man, who lost his life in the very institution that was supposed to take care of him.
The Faqiri family is suing the province and jail staff. Newly filed court documents say guards broke three ministry policies when using the spit hood. The policy states staff must ensure an inmate is not placed on their stomach or any other position that could result in positional asphyxia, is not left unattended when wearing a spit hood, and says an inmate must be properly decontaminated when pepper spray is used. There's also a warning label on the packaging of the spit hood that reads, "Improper use can cause injury or death and may cause asphyxiation, suffocation, or drowning in one's own fluids." Under questioning by the Faqiri family's lawyer, a jail sergeant who has since been fired says she would never combine the use of pepper spray and a spit hood when someone is on their stomach, their hands cuffed behind them. Then she's asked, "The reason you don't do that is because that would be basically a triple threat of asphyxia." Her response, "Absolutely." That sergeant had gone to Fakiri's cell during the altercation. She was one of the last to leave the cell, but says she stayed just outside of the closed door and kept her eye on Faqiri through a window. After about a minute, she noticed he wasn't breathing. The documents also say that's when she noticed for the first time he had a spit hood on. She says it appeared to be filled with fluid or vomit.
A perfect storm, you know, where combinations of things can happen that lead to a death.
Michael Burgess conducts use of force training and says the case brings up questions about restraint asphyxia, a position that can restrict someone's ability to breathe.
There's a number of things that we've learned over the last 40 or 50 years about asphyxia. One of the major lessons initially learned is never to leave a prisoner face down on the ground in handcuffs any longer than you absolutely have to.
In a statement, the jail sergeant's lawyer said in part, "We will let the process determine where the real culpability in this matter lies. My clients have been scapegoated by their employer for their heroic efforts to avert the tragic result in this incident." The Ministry of the Solicitor General wouldn't comment on the case because it's before the courts. No criminal charges have been laid, and the coroner deemed Faqiri's cause of death unascertained.
Even though it was shocking, disappointing, this tragedy, justice still seems to be elusive. They didn't just fail Soleiman Faqiri. They didn't just fail the Faqiri family. They failed every Canadian who's suffering from mental illness.
These new revelations are just one more step in the Faqiri family's quest for accountability. Ultimately, they'd like to see criminal charges laid against all the guards who were involved. Angelina King, CBC News, Toronto.